So okay guys, so previously we have completed our pad command, pocket command, shaft command, groove command, hole command and rib and slot command. So today what we are going to see is solid combine, the stiffener and the multi-section solid and the removed multi-section solid. Okay, so we'll quickly move on to our first command, that is solid combine. Okay, so solid combine is a feature in which you can combine, means when you draw a sketch, you make it pad into a particular direction which is perpendicular to the plane on which we draw. So suppose I'll show you an example of it. So suppose I select this plane, the YZ plane, I'll sketch on it. Suppose I draw a square, a centered rectangle, I'll make it a square. Okay, I'll give the dimension to be 100 by 100. Okay guys, so we have drawn our first sketch. For this feature to work, we'll actually need two sketches. So I'll make another sketch on another plane. So I'll suppose select this XY plane as my next sketch on which I'll, next plane on which I'll draw my next sketch. Okay, so I've selected the plane, I'll go into sketcher. Now I'll draw a profile, maybe some different profile or whatever profile for simplicity. First of all I'll select maybe I'll select this. Okay, so I'll exit my workbench. So now what I've got here is two sketches. One is in this plane and another one is on this plane. Okay, so what I'm going to use is the solid combine feature. I'll click on it. So as you can see, I'm getting here two options, first component and the second component. For the first component, the software is asking me for a profile, and for the second component it is also asking me a profile. So I'll have to select the profile. So I'll select this profile, and for the next profile I'll select this profile. So as you can see, what has the software done is it has extruded this particular sketch, which is this, okay, which is this sketch. It has extruded it in both the direction up to the point where it meets the square. Okay, likewise the square has also been extruded in the direction perpendicular. It means it has extruded in this particular direction, okay, up to the plane up to which it intersects with this curve. Okay, so what has resulted in it is actually this 3D model. So if I click on preview, you'll see, means the sketch which I had drawn has extruded up to the limits of the square, and this square has extruded up to the up to here limits. Okay, so when I click on OK, what you get is a combination of two sketches which I had drawn earlier. So I'll draw another sketch for you to understand. Suppose I select this feature and I draw an arbitrary sketch like using profile. Suppose I draw a sketch like this. Okay, so I've drawn a sketch. Let's see whether the sketch is closed or not. The sketch is closed. Okay, so there's no problem with that. I'll exit the workbench. Now what the next thing which I have to do is draw another sketch on another plane. I'll select the plane, I'll go into the sketcher. Now what I have to do is make another profile. So I've closed the sketch. For no doubt you must always check the sketch analysis and see whether your profile is closed or not. Okay, so my profile is closed. So now I'll exit the workbench. Now what we have got over here is a two sketches on two mutually perpendicular planes. Okay, so what I am going to use now is the solid combine feature. I have already selected sketch 4 as my first profile. Now I'm going to select this sketch as my second profile. Now as you can see, this profile has extruded up to the extent of the next profile. Okay, this is my first profile, this is my second profile, and wherever they are meeting, as you can see, this profile has extruded up to the plane where it meets the first profile. Now from the top view, if you see, my second profile is extruding up to the limits of the first profile. Okay, so what we get here is a 3D model out of a 2D sketch. Okay, so maybe you would have got an idea of what the actually multi solid combined feature actually do. Okay, so we have completed our first feature, that is solid combine. Okay, so now we'll quickly move on to another feature, that is stiffener. Okay, so for stiffener I'll require another type of geometry. Suppose I'll select this plane, I'll sketch on it. Let me make a profile quickly. So the work of the stiffener is basically to strengthen two adjacent plates or elements which may be perpendicular or non-perpendicular. So suppose I have drawn this profile. If I pad it, I'll give the dimension to be 100. Okay, now suppose if there is a stress on this, if we put some weight on it, it may deform or it may shear across this plane from here to here. Okay, so to prevent this from occurring, we give stiffeners to the faces. Okay, so for stiffeners, actually you'll require a profile. So what I'll do here is I'll select the sketch plane, go into sketcher. Now I'll draw a line which would be my profile. Okay, a line which is an open profile and its end point should intersect with the face of the planes. Okay, with the planes of the two adjacent planes. Okay, so I've drawn my stiffener. This line, when it extends, it will intersect with this plane, and this end point, when I elongate it or extend it, it would intersect with this plane. Okay, so I've drawn a profile. Okay, so if I come out of this sketcher, now what I will do is I'll create a stiffener. Okay, now it is asking me the thickness of the stiffener. Okay, and now first of all I'll select the profile, that is this profile. Okay, I've selected the profile. Now it is showing me some error. For this I'll make some changes over here in my pad. Okay, what I'll do is I'll change it to mirror direction. Okay, so now I select my profile. Now what I've got here is a stiffener which will strengthen the shearing of, which will prevent the shearing of this 3D model. Okay, when it is loaded, so you can give the thickness from here. So as you can see, as I give the thickness of this increases. Okay, so you can select the directions also, you can reverse it, or you can make it the way it is. Okay,